Welcome to a new test and teardown video. I think this one is also going to be a part of the homebrew series, but I'm not sure. What exactly is this? I see and like input and outputs and some common and some on and off. This one is then connected to that one, and then what is then connected to, and we see some AB, and then I don't know exactly what is going on here. What the? Yeah, so I think I would call this a homebrew kind of thing, but the two modules here, they are ready-made or something like that, right? They're not homemade, but the case and the installation here is definitely homemade. The power supply board is absolutely homemade. What have we got here? Let's get some light in there. Oh yeah, so there's an IC down there that gets hot and it's mounted to the rear plate like that. And yes, it reads power supply. A big surprise on the PCB. So this is definitely a homemade PCB. Oh, there was a tiny little bridge rectifier there. And two very big capacitors. And that is for the LED is connected directly to the ground of the capacitors or yeah, rectifiers. And that is connected to the input ground. So this is a perfect way to create a hum loop, but of course in a high impedance. But anyway, why would you light up the LED with critical clock signals return path? But anyway. Okay, this is weird. If you see the red wires to that switch, that will be the signal. So if you turn on that switch, you connect A and B together. Okay. But then again, the next switch, that is the same. So you can also connect this and this together. And this goes on. And it's the same. Oh yeah, it's the same down here as well. But that is written here with the lines. So that will be able to connect to that. Okay, so what exactly is this module doing? We've got something that can go in, and that is definitely connected together, by the way. This input, that is the same. And then we've got a clock. So what is this? And also, I don't know about this solution for holding. It's not holding anything. How about we look at the PCBs? What is that? So now I took out the two PCBs and they look very much identical. If you look a little careful here, you can see up here, can you see that in the middle of the picture it says Reticon? And 75 SC1024. And this chip is called Reticon SAD1024. It's from 1964. And yes, this is the other one as well. Then we got some opamps, the two silver ones, that will be opamps, and the 1413. There will be some flip-flops, and they are making an inverted and a true clock to the Reticon. This is actually a delay line that will delay samples, and as far as I know, this is a two-channel analog delay line with like 512 steps. So every time you give it a clock, it moves the analog signal through a delay line. So you can connect this back again to the input and make it like an echo, a reverb, or all sorts of analog and digital effects on analog signals. So it's probably going to sound really, really cool what this thing can do. And then we've got two of them, so we've got four channels. And if you look up this chip on eBay or anywhere, people are willing to pay $100 just for this chip alone. And what we got here is genuine Reticon demo boards from 1975, including all the analog stuff and the chips in sockets. And this is even the extended temperature or military grade versions we got here. So I think we found some gold here, really, if it works. Or if they work. We're gonna figure this out in a second. But I think I'm going to boot up this. It's definitely a homemade system to test them or to use them for something. I want to test the power supplies. They are good before I blow up those two nice modules. So that is what I want to do first. Let's just look a few seconds at the data sheet of this SAD1024 delay line. So here's exactly what I was thinking about, a chorus effect, and especially we can do now a four level chorus. It's going to sound fantastic. If we see, it's typical 15 volts. And this is also what we have on this board. I wanted to show you guys, this is how it works with all the different phases. So every time there is a phase shift, positive, negative here, the analog signals kind of jump through all the different stages in this system. So of course you want to have a very, very high sample frequency, and this gives you also a better resolution in the in the analog domain, obviously. So about clocking, also on this PCB we saw the 4013, and this is doing the positive and inverted clock just like this. Other than that, I don't think I wanted to show you guys a lot of extra stuff. This is how you can run them in parallel, blah 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 blah. Not a lot of interesting stuff. You're more than welcome to go and download this data sheet yourselves and have a lot of fun with this, but I don't think you will be able to get this part because it's completely obsolete, and it's actually a lot of years ago since it was obsolete. That is just too bad, because it could be a lot of fun to play with. So yeah, I think I am ready to show a little demo of what this can do. So this is the incoming signal. Hey, how about we gain this up a little bit so we can see what we're doing, right? So, incoming and output from the last, hang on. Yeah, I think this is better. So this is the last output. You can of course connect output, input, and so on. So you can get all four delay lines. Then you can play with the clock. Here I got clock in and clock out. This is connected together, so that means it is the same clock to all four modules. But you don't need to do that. You can use this with different clock inputs. I just flip the switch to make everything the same, and I'm just using this system to connect them so I can have it this channel here on my scope. So that is clocks. So right at the moment, I got the sine wave is 1 kilohertz, and this is just a single burst. Okay, just so we can see the delay and what is going on. And then I'm playing with the clock frequency, and then let's see what happens to the output. So this is the clock, yeah, 5 kilohertz. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. See what happens to the digital resolution. So this is now, this is quite interesting, isn't it? So this is 30 kilohertz clock. And the higher clock, the higher resolution. I think we have a problem with the repeat and the delay. I think I should actually give it much more. Hang on a second. Much more delay. Yeah, I was definitely not showing this in a good way. So now my sine wave is bursting only once per 1 second. And now this is the output. So you can see this is 2465 milliseconds of delay from input to output. And this is at 30 kilohertz clock. So now if I crank up the clock, see, delay gets much shorter. So let's just keep it here. Let's move the output one step in, one closer to the source. See, now the delay is much shorter. Can I go one more? That is shorter again. Let's go all the way. See, this is only one. Okay, so let's zoom in. See the input and the output. So this is 10 millisecond delay. And let's just play a little bit with the sine wave, because there isn't a lot to look at here, right? So this is the 1 kilohertz. Let's go down in 100 hertz. Yes. Why isn't that having any effect? That is weird, isn't it? Then it stopped working. That is weird. I mean, that is definitely a bug I found in my signal generator. Did you see that? So when I changed the update, the frequency, it messed up the burst. How annoying. But anyway, this is, again, the input and the output. And let's play with the sample frequency. And then, see, I can change the delay. So this is definitely what this unit can do. And of course I need to have a very high clock frequency to get good resolution. If I go down in clock, I think it's actually better to see if we go and change the trigger to the output. So now we're looking at only at the output and the quality of this signal is looking a little bit like this, right? Now we can really see what we're doing here, okay? And then let me crank down the sample rate. And then you get an output where you can start to see the sample frequency. So I think you can make a really lot of funny synthesizer setups or all sorts of funny sample sounds using this unit. All you need is a signal generator to input the clock frequencies, or even four different clock frequencies. Imagine you put in some audio into all four of them, and then mix the audio from all the outputs here, and then you can make like a four voice of your singing. It's going to make the audio much wider in real time. It's definitely interesting to try and put this on a mixer and some audio. I didn't really expect this to be so super cool. Let's try and get up in the sample frequency, and let's see how high we can go. According to the data sheet, 200 kilohertz should be the max, right? Or was it? Okay, so it is probably a lot higher. So this is 1 megahertz of clock. And see, now I got almost no delay. The input and the output is just top of each other, right? So this is 1 megahertz. Let's just, yeah, okay, then it craps. Okay. Okay, that's 4 megahertz. And then we have 3, 2, and 1. And then we start to see a little bit of delay at 1 megahertz. So yeah, that is, and that was zero. That was a little bit about how this fantastic delay line is working. Definitely a fun product to play with. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you had fun. To add some very important information, the input is plus minus 1 volt maximum. If I give it more, see, this is 1.1, 2, 3. See what happens? Then we got clipping, and that happens at 1.2. So I say, let's try to play with the negative again. 1, 2. Okay, I'm dialing the wrong way. There's also 1.2 negative where we see clipping. So don't give it any more. That's just what I wanted to add.